Hello, good morning. I am Dr. Suman Govil. I worked as senior advisor in Department of Biotechnology. During my vast experience spanning over 36 years in Department of Biotechnology, I had an opportunity to interact with students from undergraduate star colleges, from universities conducting postgraduate teaching programs, PhD and postdoc students, as well as students for biotech industrial training program and finishing school program of Department of Biotechnology. What we realized was that students have no idea about various career options available to them other than academics and research. One of the possible reasons could be that the teachers themselves are involved in academics and research and have very little information about other career options, or that's what they think is the best for students. However, some of the students who are unable to join academics or are not interested in pursuing PhD and want to join industries would need some guidance. I have also received a message from one of the students on my blog that I should post some video messages. So here is my first attempt. I hope it will be handy for the students. Today, I am going to guide the students who are willing to transition into industry. So my first video will be on how to write your resume. When we talk to students and ask them what have you been doing for last 1 year after you completed your MSc, they say, I'm trying for a job. When we ask them, where have you tried for jobs? They say, I post my bio data on Naukri.com or other some such similar sites. Unfortunately, they do not receive any response, which is along the expected lines because the companies do not even look at such biodata. So how do you discriminate from other such applications so that the HR manager in the company would be at least looking at your resume? So that is going to be my today's goal. So how do you do this? You know, I think you are not working with the perhaps a good strategy. Just posting your resume on sites is not going to get you even a call for an interview, leave aside a job. So you are spending your disproportionate time in, you know, looking at the advertisements, trying to post your resume, without making any efforts on networking and getting some referrals and understanding what are the industry's expectations and how can you make your resume tailor-made to the needs and expectations of the industry. So you need to adopt a strategy, viable job strategy. So you should spend significant amount of your time in networking and generating referrals so that you will come to know about jobs which are not even advertised on online portals or in newspapers or in other such magazines. You must understand that 40% of new hirees are actually recruited through word of mouth. So if you know somebody in an industry, be in touch with that person so that he can get you in touch with HR manager and also tell you about various openings or future openings which may be coming in the company. The small and medium sized companies hire rapidly and they do not have time and, you know, they do not want to invest money in putting advertisements for recruitment, and they hire through contacts. So you should also carefully, you know, have your LinkedIn profile and select job titles and use appropriate keywords in your resume. You should also make use of technology and in a manner that you get job alerts and notifications whenever any new job is advertised in a field which may be relevant to you. Also choose names of companies, you know, shortlist names of companies in which you are interested. For example, biotechnology will have implications in pharmaceutical industry, agriculture industry, tissue culture based, seed based, GM crops based, service industry, you know, clinical trials and CROs and so on and so forth. So shortlist industries in which you may be interested depending on their profile, also your geographical preferences, and make sure that you get notification alerts about any job openings in those companies. Also try to build relevant contacts. You must understand that these companies receive thousands of applications for each post which they may be advertising. Sometimes even without an advertisement, they may be getting thousands of such resumes. So how do they, you know, shortlist? So you must make your resume in a manner that tells the company that you are perhaps one of the most suitable candidate for the opening in their company. How do you do that? Do not exaggerate, be very persuasive, and highlight your significant accomplishments and tailor-make to the needs and expectations of an industry. Suppose you are going to work in a pharma industry, you have done some work on drug design, or if you are going to work in protein purification, you have done some animal experiments. So you must tell them that you have the relevant expertise and experience, you are a team person, how you have managed extramural funding in the team in which you worked, and personnel management, if you have organized some events. You must highlight, because the companies are really interested in those interpersonal traits. So do not give too much information in your biodata. Restrict to, it's actually not biodata, it's a resume, because your CV, curriculum vitae, is going to be, you know, highlighting all your academic qualifications, year of passing, percentage received, which is not relevant here. So they may not be even interested to see your list of publications. Just give numbers and just give the most relevant one or two. Focus on your strong professional summary statement. It should be clear, concise, precise, and professional. Maybe you can give 3 bullet points which will cover relevant accomplishments, technical skills and expertise, and soft skills and personality traits which are relevant to the role for which you are applying. Quantify your results. Use numbers, number of publications, conferences attended, funding generated, events organized. You must realize that HR manager is at best going to spend 6 to 7 seconds on your resume. So do not give unimportant or irrelevant information. Plan your resume very aesthetically. Do not have any proofreading mistakes. And do not use text language in your forwarding letter. It should be easy to read, and it must specify transferable skills, technical skills, and results which you have achieved. You must realize that you must submit your resume directly to a person. Not in an online portal or to CEO or HR manager. It gives a very wrong impression if you've not even bothered to look at the name of the person who's involved. In such cases, you know, 80% chances are there that this will be rejected by automatic tracking softwares. So you must realize that if you are really looking for a job, you must make concerted efforts and make it appear that you are really serious about the job and it means a lot to you. I will also, in my subsequent videos, guide you on how to make your profile on LinkedIn, how to network for referrals, how to prepare for interviews, maybe, you know, how to prepare presentations if you get a chance to make a presentation, and so on. I also request that you give me feedback and comments and your needs, so that it's a two-way process and would also keep me interested and motivated. I would be very happy if it would help even a few students who are interested to transition into other jobs. I could also tell you about, you know, if you want to go into science communication or you want to go into IPR and regulation, what kind of soft skills they are expecting you to have, and if you need any eligibility and qualifications, where to pursue that from. So this will be a continuous process if I keep receiving feedback from you. Thank you so much for your attention.